One of the benefits of large language models is that they're a lot more flexible than code. This means they can handle all sorts of problems that code or even a workflow couldn't handle previously. When you're using a tool like ChatGPT or Claude and can give feedback on what the LLM produces, this flexibility and creativity is an asset. However, when you're trying to integrate AI into an existing system, this type of variable output can actually be a liability. For example, if you have an AI block in a workflow, you likely need the LLM to produce a reasonable answer in one shot without the chance to give feedback. This means you need more consistent output from your LLMs. Luckily, there are a few different ways to leverage LLMs and still get consistent output that can augment and even control your apps and workflows. Let's take a look at some of your options. One of the easiest ways to get more consistent output is to adjust the temperature that you're using to prompt your LLM. Lower values of temperature produce more focused and deterministic output, while higher values produce more random output. Lowering the temperature means you'll get more consistent output from your prompt, even if you don't change anything else. LLMs are pretty great at interpreting natural language, but you should still distinguish which part of your input is the instructions for the model and which part is the contextual data that it can use to help generate its output. Providing delimiters between instructions and data provided for context can help the LLM tell the difference. Delimiters can be anything from triple quotes to backticks to labeling the various sections of your prompt. Another technique that's very effective is wrapping your data in semantic tags. For example, we're asking the AI to summarize a given passage. We can wrap the actual text in a tag called text to summarize, which helps the LLM separate this from our instructions. You can ask an LLM to output information to you using these same tags. This allows you to distinguish between the LLM explaining the output and the actual portion of the output that you care about. A nice side effect is that you can then use a regex to parse out the output you actually care about and use it in your apps and workflows, regardless of if the LLM's explanation or other output text changes. LLMs are also pretty good at outputting other structured formats they're familiar with, especially if they have a few examples. Here, we're asking the language model to output JSON and giving it an example of the type of JSON object we expect. LLMs are powerful tools that unlock an entirely new set of capabilities. In a future video, we'll take a look at how to actually apply these techniques in your apps and workflows. See you next time.